In this week's space news, Isar Aerospace is advancing its testing phase with an inaugural flight scheduled in the coming months. Toyota is investing in Interstellar, a Japanese startup focused on designing and building orbital rockets. Spaceium, a startup specializing in orbital refueling, has secured over $6 million in funding to complete its first demonstration mission. And lastly, Inversion Space, which is developing re-entry capsules, has successfully launched its first satellite into orbit via SpaceX rideshare mission. Okay, let's get started. Isar Aerospace nears first launch. The Norwegian government has announced that Isar Aerospace expects to conduct its first flight of its two-stage Spectrum rocket in the next few months. All components for the first Spectrum rocket have arrived at Andøya spaceport in Norway. Isar has confirmed that they've begun static fire tests for both the rocket's first and second stages. They tested their engines in Norway towards the end of 2024, but had to pause due to bad weather in December. Testing has resumed this month as the weather has improved, allowing Isar engineers to qualify their engines and stages. Isar has secured a long-term agreement with Andøya Spaceport to launch their Spectrum rockets from this facility. Although we have no launch date yet, it could happen in the first half of 2025, if all the testing goes well. As with all spaceflight, one bad test could cause months of delays. A case in point is Rocket Factory Augsburg, which was set to launch in late 2024, but suffered a big setback when the engine test at Saxefjord resulted in a fire, leading to the total loss of their vehicle and all nine engines. We will keep you updated on Isar Aerospace and other European space startups, many of which are aiming to send their first rockets into space this year. Now, let's move on to the second story of the week. Toyota backs Japanese space startup Interstellar to mass-produce rockets. Toyota are not complete strangers to space. They are working on building a lunar rover for the Japanese Space Agency that will carry astronauts on the moon's surface as part of the NASA-led Artemis program. They have now decided to invest in a prominent Japanese space startup called Interstellar. Regular viewers of this channel will already be familiar with this company, as I've reported on them already. Check out that video for details. Toyota will invest 7 billion yen, that's approximately $44 million in Interstellar. This will help them complete their first orbital rocket called Zero. Interstellar has already launched a suborbital rocket in 2019, but its orbital launch Zero hasn't flown yet. A rival of Interstellar, Space One, recently tried for the second time to fly an orbital rocket called Kairos. While the attempt was far more successful than the first launch, it failed to reach orbit and the flight was terminated after the rocket lost stability and began to tumble. Space One and Interstellar are trying to be the first Asian space startup to reach orbit. A third possible contender is InnoSpace in South Korea. Who knows, perhaps this year, one of those companies will successfully send a rocket into orbit. You can be sure we'll keep you informed on these companies and their progress. Okay, on to our next story this week. Spaceium, a company working on orbital refueling, raises over $6 million in funding. Spaceium has recently announced that they've raised $6.3 million in an oversubscribed seed round. They claim to have a strong pipeline of customers for their orbital refueling technology. Currently, when a satellite exhausts its onboard fuel, it becomes useless as it can no longer maintain its orbit. These satellites, often worth millions, could potentially function for decades if only they could be refueled in space. That's where Spaceium steps in. They offer their customers the ability to refuel satellites in orbit, resulting in an extended lifespan and, ultimately, more revenue for their customers. Spaceium's vision is to create a space superhighway with multiple refueling stations where spacecraft can dock, refuel, and proceed with their missions, similar to petrol stations on roads or fuel bunkers in ports and harbours. However, Spaceium isn't the only player in this field. Other companies like Astroscale and OrbitFab also plan to refuel satellites in orbit, often referred to as life extension missions. Spaceium boasts a competitive edge, stating, "We have actually developed a very unique system where we can store the fuel for longer periods of time, which was actually not done before." Unquote. They are keeping the specifics of their system under wraps though. The company is currently gearing up for their first demonstration mission, having developed several prototypes, confident that they have the technology to make orbital refueling a reality. Some of their customers require multiple metric tons of fuel per mission. Spaceium wants to partner with both government and commercial space programs, as well as businesses working in space, the moon, or Mars. We'll continue to update you on Spaceium and other startups that are venturing into this orbital refueling economy. Now, let's move on to a company focused on space delivery technology. Inversion Space aims to make space delivery a reality. At the moment, it's difficult and expensive to return materials from space. This could include scientific experiments, manufactured items, or any other materials. Their first test satellite, called Ray, was lifted into orbit on a SpaceX transporter mission on the 14th of January 2025. It successfully deployed and appears to be in full working order. It will stay in orbit for a few weeks before re-entering the atmosphere. Inversion Space has structured Ray's mission into three phases. The first phase, the current one, is in the in-orbit phase, where Ray circles the Earth while the ground team checks data to ensure all systems are operating nominally. The second phase, deorbit, involves the team sending a signal to fire the satellite's engine, guiding Ray towards Earth's atmosphere. The third and final phase, re-entry, sees Ray re-entering the atmosphere enduring heat with the aim of slowing down enough to land softly. This is an ambitious mission for a new space startup. Inversion has designed and built most systems themselves, including the CE1 deorbit engine, propulsion system, structures, software, separation systems, parachutes, and much of the avionics. These systems on board Ray will also be included in a larger vehicle called Arc. Inversion plans to deorbit the satellite, aiming for landing off the coast of California. The deorbit burn represents the mission's highest risk element. Even if this fails, the data collected will be invaluable for refining future vehicle designs. We'll keep you updated on Inversion Space, particularly as they attempt the re-entry in the coming weeks. Okay, that's it for this week. Be sure to like and subscribe so you see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.